Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video guys, I'm gonna show you two different TIG root techniques on this horizontal setup. As you can see here, gap is a 6.5 mil. It's not even all the way around. There's a little bit difference on one side, is like 4.5 mil. Just to give you an idea, with 1/8 TIG rod, how big gap it is. I did this setup on purpose, just to show you. So I'm gonna put three tacks. This is a little bit to show you how the tack looks like on a big gap like this. I always do top and the bottom, then I connect in the middle and just stretch that paddle down from the top down. It's gonna be three root tacks on this weld. This is the first one. I'm just gonna check. For the size here, as I said, it's like 6.5 mil. Definitely this is not beginner friendly. It's more for guys who are already familiar with TIG and they want to challenge themselves. So you know, as in a field, it's never ideal. You got smaller gap, you got tight gap, you got big gaps. It all depends. So it's good to know, you know, different things, different tips, different techniques. It's gonna help you down on the road. As I said, this is second gap, same thing from the top down, stretching that puddle. And I got three tacks, all of them it's gonna be, I'm gonna use grinder, and on each tack, both sides, I'm just gonna grind exit and entry point. So this is one of the techniques I'm gonna use. It's gonna be from the bottom up, stretching that puddle. We're gonna just challenge the gravity here and different physics laws. It's good to know different things, you know. And the other technique is gonna be from the top down. I'm just gonna start on the tack and I'm gonna hold that filler wire up on the top edge of that bevel and stretch that paddle down. In my previous videos, I did one with horizontal weld and it was like loose 1/8 532 gap. I was holding a rod in the middle and did some dipping technique. But for this one, it's a little bit different story. As I said, as you can see, it's a bigger gap. So I'm gonna start once that tack is preheated enough. I'm gonna add wire and keep that rod at the top and stretch that paddle down. It's a little bit challenging here, but nothing to worry about. Settings 115 for tacks and for the root as well, for entire root. I did with this amperage. 115 is good enough. If it's too high, you can always lower it down. But I mean, I think this should work. Okay, this is the part of the root I did. So this one was at the top side. And now we're gonna do from the bottom up. I'm just gonna continue on that weld I did. So the same idea, only opposite side. Keep the rod on the bottom. And just stretch that paddle down. You can always change that angle inclination. It's a little bit extremes angles sometimes, just to fight that gravity, to keep that paddle to stick up at the top side of the bevel, just to stay there. You can always you have to little twist, changing the angles as you travel, as you go around. It's not always the same. As you push that paddle, as you can see, it's a little bit challenging as you're fighting gravity and also that top edge wants to open, but you don't want to open too much as you're gonna get internal undercuts. Definitely you want to avoid that. Just enough to hold that tungsten behind that paddle, so the tungsten is actually pushing that paddle up. And this is the other section of the root with that bottom part technique. I'm just gonna show you a different view from here just to see the uniformity of the root. It's not excessive, it's a good root. It's a good solid root for this size of the gap. Okay, this is for the stick out, 8 mil. Usually my reference is like I always like to push at the edge of the bevel, but in this case as the gap is a little bit bigger, we're not gonna go too much with the stick out. And in this case I'm just gonna show you a tie-in, how to do tie-in. I know you guys had a couple comments, couple questions to show you a little closely with the tie-ins, and okay, I'm gonna show you now in this one. I'm still there holding that rod at the bottom, stretching that paddle up, and now we're close to that tie-in. It's pretty much like for any tie-ins, just gonna pause a little bit here, top and bottom, more at the bottom than on the top in this case, and just add wire as needed, you know. Just add wire as needed, and then I'm gonna stop here at the middle. Okay, now I got like 3/4 of the root is done on this pipe. Just gonna show you one more view, so you can see the build up, the uniformity of the root. As I said, this is a really good root for this size of the gap. Okay, now I'm gonna show you a little tip here. This tip works well always, especially in the field, the tight spots, on ideal conditions and all that. So in this case, I'm holding at the top, and now I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna reposition myself. Okay, I pull the tungsten, pull the torch back, and then pushing back forward. So you can reposition, you know, if you got like, uncomfortable spot, and then you want to reposition but you don't want to stop while you're welding, you can always pull that torch, drag it on the weld, reposition. You can even push, like if you stuck with a filler wire, you can stuck reposition, push it more through the fingers, you know, or whatever. That's one of the good tips, works good. You don't have to stop, as I said. Especially if you're using torch like I do, there's no any stop start or pause options on a torch, so you can just push it back and bring it back forward and reposition your filler rod in this case, and just continue on with welding. As you can see in this case, I did switch top and the bottom. I was holding at the top and then I switch on the bottom, and vice versa. Okay, and that's it for the root in this video. It's gonna show you the whole root I did with those two techniques and that little tip. It might help you down in the road, especially in a field. That's it pretty much, guys. I hope you like it. Thank you for your support so far. Hope you learned something new. You can challenge yourself. It's always good to challenge yourself. And see you in the next one, guys. Take care.